Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Nice to see you back. Back to making videos after 15 days. So finally, it's that time of the year round again. This new year has started. So first of all, wish each one of you a very, very, very happy new year. It's 8th January today, but I think I could still wish each one of you. And the eclipse is around the corner, the lunar eclipse in the nakshatra of Punarvasu is going to take place in the next 48 hours almost. So this is a very important eclipse. Of course, every eclipse is important, but this eclipse is especially important because this eclipse is in between different transits which are happening. Or which had already happened. So for example, Saturn, Shani Maharaj has entered Uttarashada Nakshatra in end of December and Jupiter has entered Purvashada Nakshatra recently in 7th of January 2020. And Saturn is going to enter the second pada of Uttarashada, which will be in Capricorn. So Saturn is changing the sign itself. And he's going to enter his own house, own sign. So this is a very important transit. And Ketu is also going to enter Mula Nakshatra. Or maybe it has already entered. The last time I saw it was in 14 or 13 degrees. So maybe it has already entered. And depending on you take true Rahu or you know mean Rahu. So depending on that Ketu I mean. So Ketu's journey in Mula Nakshatra has also started. So therefore, this eclipse which is happening is very crucial because this time, we all know when an eclipse takes place, when Sun and Moon are in a close proximity with Rahu and Ketu. Okay, so around at 25 degrees of Gemini, let me just check the chart, 25 degrees, Sun is at 25 degrees of Sagittarius and Moon will be again at 25. And Rahu is at around 14 degrees, Rahu Ketu, all right? So this is almost around 12 degrees of the eclipse, but still it's a very prominent eclipse. All right, so this eclipse will be in Punarvasu Nakshatra, which means Moon will be in the Nakshatra of Punarvasu. Rahu will be in Ardhara Nakshatra, okay? And Sun is in Purvashada Nakshatra. And we also have planets like Mercury, which is conjunct Sun in Purvashada Nakshatra. And Shani Maharaj, Saturn is in Uttarashada, of course, right? So these planets like Mercury and Saturn, and of course, Jupiter in Purvashada. How can I forget Jupiter? So these three planets are taking part in this eclipse, right? So wherever the Gemini Sagittarius axis is falling in your chart, depending on your ascendant, should I repeat, depending on your ascendant, for the next 6 months at least, those things will keep playing around your life, right? And this is happening in Punarvasu, and the nakshatra Purvashada is also very closely associated with this. Why is Purvashada very important here? Not only because Sun is in Purvashada, okay? Because the dispositor of Moon, which is Mercury, because Moon is in Gemini, Moon is going to be in Gemini, is also in Purvashada, in Sagittarius, all right? So, therefore, this becomes very important. So, let us try to understand this in short, and as usual, whatever I say here will not apply 100% to you. It can apply maybe 0 or 10% or 5% or 90% depending on your horoscope. And it all depends on how strong your Mercury is and how strong your Venus is, because Venus is the dispositor of Purvashada. He's the lord of Purvashada Nakshatra. Okay. And also Jupiter, Lord Punarvasu. So therefore, Jupiter and Venus are the most important planets for this eclipse, right? So therefore, If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding this eclipse, then you can always go to my description section down below where you will find the website. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So what is this eclipse? This eclipse is happening in Punarvasu. So we can go to an astrological explanation, but if you try to make things simple, what this eclipse can make you feel like? Well, Punarvasu Nakshatra has things related to, you know, Punara means again. Now, again, necessarily, there are many different translations of the word Punara. If you go to Sanskrit, the word Punara, there are many different translations. So one of the translations is that something new comes, or something which you are already doing comes back, or something new comes to something which you are already doing. So it's not that you may repeat something, but you may do the same thing in a different way. That also is represented by Punarvasu Nakshatra. Now, what is Purvashada? Punarvasu and Purvashada are totally opposite, if you see. Okay. What is Purvashada? Purvashada refers to, Purvashada, as you know, it is after Mula Nakshatra, which is after Jyeshtha Nakshatra. So in Jyeshtha Nakshatra, we take action depending on our free will. And in Mula Nakshatra, we face the consequences of our free will, of our actions, I mean. And in Purvashada, what happens? Purvashada, the result comes. In Purvashada, the result manifests. And in Uttarashada, we actually understand what we did was right or wrong. And then in Shravana, we sit and introspect what is going on. So Purvashada Nakshatra, especially because Punarvasu's Lord Jupiter is in Purvashada because he has just entered. So therefore, this is the time when some area of your life, depending on the houses which Jupiter rules in your chart as per your ascendant, they will give you a flavor that something is now manifesting. Now, what is manifesting, to what extent, that will depend on your horoscope. But sometimes, as my guru used to say, no, your best need not be the best. Should I repeat? Your best need not be the best. So sometimes we see that in this world we put a lot of efforts, but we don't get results as we expect. Okay. Why that happens? Because now that happens, of course, because of our karma. But the problem is we do not know the philosophy of the Gita. The Gita says, you know, that our actions alone does not determine our results. There are many other factors. There are 5 factors the Gita talks about which we will discuss in detail some other day. But whatever is in our past karma, that will come provided we do the necessary efforts required for that to come. So the example is given that suppose a person says, you know, oh, I have very nice good food today in my karma to eat. So one of my friends once asked me that, okay, so you are saying whatever is there in your karma will happen. So will it happen that the food will, you know, jump from the plate like this and enter my mouth? No, it will not happen, because that food is there in your karma. But to eat that, you have to at least take your hands and put it inside your mouth. Otherwise, the food will not come inside your mouth. And now, just because you have a hand and a mouth, it doesn't mean that you can get to eat anything that day. Whatever is there in your karma, that is what you get, provided you use your hands. So these are 2 principles which we have to realize. And then what happens? When our efforts are not reciprocated by the universe or karma, whatever you want to call it, then we have a tendency to fall back to our bad habits, I would say. Or when things work out, we tend to do things in a way that can give us fulfillment in the long run. But that's very conditional, because then that makes you like a robot. You know, if things are good, only then I'll be good. If things are bad, I won't be that good, or I won't be very good at least. So therefore, in Purvashada and Punarvasu, this dynamics, I'm seeing this in my life, and maybe you can also see this in your life. The crux of this eclipse is that there's some area in your life which you have tried. You have tried and tried and tried and tried. And you have got success to some extent. Now, success can mean either what you wanted has come or what you wanted did not come, so you have given it up. And now you are thinking, should you continue on that journey, or should you take a new route, or should you take a detour, or should you take rest and come back again? Yes, because a certain change is right there on the corner. What that change is, that will depend on your horoscope. But now it is up to you to decide, do you want to embrace that change, or do you want to keep sticking to the old patterns? Now, generally they say, you know, welcome change, welcome this, welcome that. But here you have to be a bit cautious, because just because it is a change, it's not necessary that it's good for you. Good doesn't mean, not good doesn't mean it's bad for you. But it could mean that there are certain things which you might have to compromise. So now the point is, you have to decide what are your priorities in life. And depending on that, you will have to make the decision on whether to accept that change or to not accept that change. Like many people recently, when I met in South Germany, I had a fantastic yatra, you know, spiritual gathering. For around 2 weeks, I was there. Fantastic time it was. So there around, many people had told me, you know, that certainly there were some certain spiritual practices which they were doing, you know, around 10, 15, 20 years back. And now suddenly, somehow, these things are again now coming back. And now they are, so for example, what happened, it's like saying, suppose you were in a spiritual community and now you're not there. Now you're in another community. So now it could happen that you get a call from that community that, can you please come, or would you like to come? So now you have to decide, will I go there or will I not go there? You have to see what are the reasons you left that place. And now you have to see what are the things that you want in this life. So if the things that you want in this life and that phone call from the past is matching, well then perfect. You can go and join your past. That there's nothing wrong in doing that. But the only thing is, we have to make sure that the past does not degrade our consciousness. It does not make us more animalistic. It does not make us, it does not make us more and more materialistic. And if it elevates us, it could happen that you are in a certain place, but in the past you had such great things, you know. So therefore, we have to use the energy of this Punarvasu Nakshatra. Because see, wherever sun is, the manifestation takes place there. So this is like saying, sun is in Purvashada. So ultimately the manifestation will come out there in Purvashada. So sun is like your existence, you know, it's like what you want in this life. So the things from the past, if they help you to get a better future, you can go there. But suppose your horoscope is very challenging and you are running a difficult dasha, then it could happen that certain things which you were doing in the past, which you should have not done, you again get temptations to do those things. And always remember, in this eclipse, Saturn is involved. Saturn is leaving, of course, on 24th, 25th, but still the last almost 2 weeks, more than two and a half weeks are remaining. So, and Saturn is also in very close proximity with the sun, you know, almost in 5 degrees. So Saturn is a very important planet when it comes to this transit, this eclipse. So always remember, whenever Saturn enters any conjunction or eclipse, in short, it's not easy. All right. So because of that, what happens? You might think that, okay, I will fall back to my past. It's very easy. No, you have to see wherever Saturn is involved, there is a pinch involved. Okay. So either you decide to go back for getting ahead, or you decide to not go and go ahead for getting your goal, there will be a pinch involved. And what that pinch is, that will depend on, you know, which houses Saturn rules in your chart. All right. But the good thing is, because of Jupiter's aspect on Moon, you will have a higher sense of optimism. Now, Jupiter is very far from the Moon, if you see degree-wise, and Saturn is very close. So, the sense of hopelessness and despair can at times be more than the sense of inspiration and happiness. Okay, but at the least, it is there. And that's what Rahu is. Rahu, of course, has to take part. Otherwise, there are no eclipses without Rahu. So Rahu makes you feel that you want it now. If you don't have it now, you've lost it. Okay. And Venus, by that time, would have reached Aquarius. Yes, tomorrow Venus is reaching Aquarius. And therefore, Venus will also have the third aspect of Saturn. So what could happen is, when you are making that choice, then it could happen that you may feel that certain things which you want will not happen. And you may feel that it will not be the way I expected it to be. That feel-good factor can be a bit challenging. But the good thing is, Venus will almost be in 1 degree and Saturn is somewhere, you know, around 27, 28 degrees. So it is hardly an aspect. Because any aspect which is, you know, more than 25 degrees, it's not considered as an aspect. So you may get a feeling that, you know, my luxuries are compromised at a certain level, but you don't have to worry. It's just a feeling. It's not reality. That's what I have seen when Saturn aspects degreeically the house, the planet, but degreeically it's very far, then there is a fear, but nothing manifests as the fear. But when Saturn is very closely aspecting degree wise, the fear is there and the reality is also restricted. You know, so at least in this case, because it's very far, so it's only the fear, it's not reality. All right, so this is a very good time for us to do different spiritual practices pertaining to Jupiter and Saturn, and especially Venus we can do. And therefore, this will really be a very good time to see what things are lying ahead and what are the things that we need to take from the past, or at least even the lessons from the past. Okay? And then move ahead in our journey, material or spiritual, or level of the soul, or career, relationships. And the next eclipse is in Gemini, of course. Solar eclipse. I don't know when is the eclipse. I have to check in the Panchang. But you will get a video. And many of you have been asking me about the Jupiter's transit into Purva Shada video, that will come out. And Saturn's transit into Uttara Shada, that will also come out. And Ketu's transit into Mula Nakshatra will also come out. Okay. And the Panchang says Ketu is still in Purva Shada. So Ketu, it's almost there in Mula. All right. So when Ketu enters Mula, we can anticipate major changes. All right. So thank you very much for your patience. And lastly, yesterday I recorded a session with Santeep ji once again. And we recorded on relationship compatibility, you know, marriage compatibility. It was amazing. It's like 1 hour, 10 minutes, 70 minutes. So I will be uploading that session soon. Not very soon, because there are many other videos which I have to make. And maybe someday I upload suddenly. All right. So thank you very much for your patience. And if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share this with anybody who you want to benefit from this eclipse. And As usual, if you want a consultation, please go to the description section below down, where you can find the link to my website. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you must find him, or else he will find you.